All right, this is Admin to Code 2020, day 23. What do we got? Crab cups, another game. Three cups. Remove. Okay. Should actually read the poem, huh? Clockwise, so this is some permutation of the numbers from 1 to 9, sure. Let's see. Okay. First cup, yeah, okay. 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 9. Three, two, eight, nine, one. 5, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1. Three, 4, 6, 7. What is happening here? I guess you just decided to shift this over to really fun. My index is getting screwed up. Probably. Hold on. Three, two, five, four, six, seven, eight, nine, one. 3, 4, 6, 7, 2, 5, 8, and 1. 1, 2, 3, so that's wrong. So picking up 913. Oh my God. Million. Okay.
right, so how do we do this quickly?
So you know the position of a number and the number at a position, right? Just a linked list. Yeah, that'll work. A simpler way. Really gonna roll my own link list. So I'm coding against the API that I'm going to have to write later. think that's it. Erase and insert. Previous should be self, and the next should be this.
I see. It's so rapid. Possibly writing a linked list in the middle of this contest is a bad idea. 3, 8, 9, 1, 2, 5, 4, 6, 7, 3, 2. That reverse for some reason. Two, five, nine, one, three, two, five, four, six, seven, nine, one, nine, two, five, eight, four, one, three, six, seven. Ten, three, four, three, two, six. Yeah, okay, so that's right. Probably fast. A lot of good test cases here, huh? Why is one messed up? Six, seven, three, eight, four, five, two, nine. Six, nine, four, two, five, three, seven, one. I should have done this in C++. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Definitely 10, right? God. That's frustrating. Okay, so instead of 9, it should be the highest number in the list, which is a million. That was so dumb. Okay. This is so slow. Nine, three, four. Okay, cool. this. Hopefully we'll print the right answer. Oh, what a stupid bug. Okay, well, I don't know. It's kind of nice that I can implement a linked list, though. Man, I am just doing really terrible on these last few days. Okay, so what's going on here? So we have this game again, although this one is, well, I guess the previous one also had no choices. These games are not that exciting. But, you know, I guess it's me and the crabs, so what can you expect? So we have some permutation of the numbers from 1 through n. In part 1, n is 9. And we're keeping track of a current number. And we pick up the next three numbers. And then you add them to that number plus 1. Right, so, I mean, we just need to follow these rules, which are not so simple. And then in part 2, it's the same thing, except that the initial list is much longer and the number of moves is also much higher. Okay, so I have done this with a linked list. And the idea is that the linked list lets us implement these operations quickly. Right, so the idea of a linked list, oh, I get to use paint, is pretty simple. It's like an alternative to a list or an array or a vector, which is that instead of storing the elements next to each other, you store all the elements separately, and they contain pointers to each other. This is usually worse than a list because you have to go through a lot more memory because they're not contiguous. But it has advantages in some cases, and this problem is one of them, for reasons that I'll explain. Right, so the idea, you know, for the sample input of whatever it was, 389. Right, so we have 3 here, and 8 here, and 9 here, and I think it's 2, 6, and, you know, there's some more stuff over here, but whatever, I don't want to dwell. Actually, it was 1, 2. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. Right, so... you just have these arrows, right? And also, there's an arrow here pointing to the end of the list, and also here. So it's a circle, which is what they say it should be. And we're also keeping a dictionary of pointers. So 3 points to this node. And 8 points to this node, right? So we can look up the nodes by value quickly. Okay, so that's the data structure that we have. That was a terrible 8. Okay, I can't draw on paint. Anyway, and so we're keeping track of some special node, which is the current one, which starts out just at the front of the list. And so what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to pick up the next three nodes. So we're going to go to this node, and this node, and this node, and we are going to delete them from the list. This is actually a 1. And just sort of keep them off to the side. Right, so that's what this is doing. And so this is a nice property of the linked list, is that you can erase a node in constant time. Whereas in a list, it takes O of n time because you need to move all of the other elements after it so that they're still contiguous, right? Because the point of the list is that it's contiguous. But in the linked list, it's not contiguous, and so you don't need to move anything. To delete an element, you just take its previous thing, which was pointing to it, and you point it, you know, to the next thing, it leaps over. And the previous thing, which had a pointer like this, similarly leaps over. And now you've basically deleted this element, right? There's no arrows pointing to it, so you can't get to it. And these elements now look like they are just right next to each other. So deleting is constant time. And I guess the other thing that we need to do when we delete is update the dictionary. So we just erase the corresponding entry in the dictionary. You know, we don't really need the head at all, actually. So, okay, maybe keeping track of the head is kind of stupid. Actually, maybe I will stop doing that then. I guess we need some node to anchor onto when we are adding. We don't really though, right? So the whole point of the refactoring that I'm trying to do is to eliminate the need to store a head node, which is kind of nice. So its previous node is prev. Its next node is let's just prev that next. I don't know if this really made anything simpler. We'll see if that runs. So anyway, the point of that is that we do not need to track the head. Okay, so we grab the first three nodes, then we find the destination, which is just the current node minus one, and you keep going if it's a pickup, and if you get it, you know, if it loops around, basically. So if you get down to zero, it goes to the end, which I screwed up. Is that still the right answer? 2188435. Cool. Okay. I didn't mess it up that much. Yeah, so this is the logic for test. This is super ugly, and also I screwed it up, so that seems bad. Is there like a simpler way to do this? I don't know. I guess it's fine. Seems very ugly. So anyway, then we find this destination node and we insert those three numbers after it. That's what this is doing. So inserting is kind of, I guess, similar to deleting. In that you just need to rearrange a couple arrows. So if you're inserting X after this node, and we have some node and we want to add X, so make X a node. We used to have our pointers like this. And so now this should point to here, this should point to here, this should point to here, and this should point to here, right? So you need to adjust four arrows. So two of the arrows are these ones, right? This is, you know, X, this is this arrow. This is this arrow. These are two arrows coming out of X. And then this is this arrow. And this is this arrow. Right, so those are the four arrows for insertion. So that's also a constant time operation. And then we can adjust the current node to be basically just the next node in the list. So we might have actually, I suppose we are probably fine on that. I don't need that call. Right, because we didn't touch the current node at all. Because we were just messing with the three nodes after it. So anyway, you just update that to the next node in the list, and you do that 10 million times, and because all of these operations are constant time, this doesn't take that long, although it takes longer than I would like. And then you find the two nodes that are clockwise of one, and you multiply them together, and that is the answer. I see. I suppose I should modify this code to also do part one. So in part two, we make the list longer. Then we do our moves, which is either 100 or 10 million. It's probably an easier way to spell 10 million. Thank you. we generalize this to be the highest number. That is not correct, I don't think. And for, I'm gonna debug this again. Seven. After 10 moves, one, five, four, six, seven, three, two, eight, nine, one. Right, we pick stuff up, so this is not even correct. Six, seven, three, eight, four, nine. Six, nine, four, two, five, eight, seven. Okay, it's right now. Six, nine, four, two, five, eight, three, seven. Eventually, this will print the answer to part two, and then we will be done. So I don't know. What is there to say here? I found like debugging this to be kind of challenging. I'm not quite sure why. guess just being careful about following all of these rules. Okay, so this in 17 seconds computes the answer. Cool, so that's done. Yeah, just too much debugging for me today, but I am like pretty happy with this final answer. I think it's kind of cool to use a linked list to solve this problem, because linked lists usually don't get so much love. And the reason why linked lists are good here is because of this constant time insert and constant time erase. In an array or a list, these are both linear time operations, because when you erase, you have to move all the elements over by one, and when you insert, you have to move all the elements to the right by one to make room for the new element. And those operations are very expensive, right? So, but in the linked list, there's no continuity. They don't have to be contiguous, so you don't need to move anything. You just need to make a new thing and move a couple arrows around. So yeah, cool day for linked lists. And that's it for day 23.